Hello, my name is Steven. Welcome to Hyfindr Tech Talks, where we focus on understanding the technology that makes the hydrogen economy work. Detecting leakages and flames is a very important aspect of this, and I'm very pleased today that I have a special guest who knows all about this. He's been working on detection essentially the last 22 years and now works for MSA, a leading supplier in this field. I'd like to give a special welcome to Claudio Fecarotta.
Hello, everyone. Thank you. Thank you, Steven, invite me, and thank you to work together with Hyfindr. That is great.
Thank you, Claudio, for coming. And I see you didn't come alone. You brought something with you here, something pretty big, that is. And can you say briefly what this is? Because it's quite heavy, I know.
Yeah, I brought some very specific safety products for you. Yeah. That is what we call the UGLD, Ultrasonic Gas Leak Detectors. That is a very special technology able to detect the leakage, like you introduced quite earlier. That is has the scope to detect the possible hydrogen leakage in open air. So that is very specific.
Okay, this can detect hydrogen leakages.
Okay. Yes, it is.
I think we will dive into this a bit more.
Maybe
detail,
later. Yeah.
But can you tell us where can we find this kind of thing and maybe even other kind of detection devices?
Sure. Maybe this is just an intro, and then we can introduce the others as well. Yeah. If we look at the these infographics that we prepare, it's a typical hydrogen fueling station. Okay.
Yes.
If you see the dots, this specific UGLD is the green one.
The green one.
And in the hydrogen fueling station, we can have different components. And we have the dispenser, we have the electrolyzer, the stock of the hydrogen, manifold somewhere, piping and conjunction between the components, right? All of those might be a possible chance of leakage. Mm-hmm. That is where the risks are. Mm-hmm. That is our scope, to protect the asset and the people, because let's not forget that residential people or even regular people is coming to fill their new hydrogen car there. So the scope of this detector, repeated in is the green one, is the center, because like an umbrella, has a coverage up to 28 meter ray, listening any possible leakage.
So that means if I'm driving up to here, for example,
correct,
with my vehicle,
yes,
even though I'm not seeing this sensor,
no,
is there a chance that it can detect the leakage anyway?
Absolutely not. No, this is a high technology. Mm-hmm. I'm going to explain you maybe later when I will introduce in deeper the technology, how does it work. But that has the scope to not be compromised by false alarm. Mm-hmm. Because there is a specific artificial neural network inside the software, which is able to listen.
Yeah, well, what I mean is, so if I drive my vehicle here, does the sensor, which is located here, also detect what's happening here?
Yeah.
Is there leakage there?
Oh, okay, it's up to 28 meters ray.
Oh, okay.
Ray.
It's all right.
360 degrees, correct.
Okay. All right, Claudio, I think I know you said
maybe
later.
Maybe we can say later.
I'm very impatient. So maybe can you tell us a little bit more how this whole setup works?
Yeah, I mean, maybe we can start to give an overview about the architecture.
Yes.
This is our electronic UGLD detector.
The one we just have on the table,
Is a set. We started maybe to introduce also the other two, but we wanted to keep later.
Yes.
So there is a typical three wires connection to a controller and then trigger any safety device like the shutdown or the ventilation. Depends on the safety procedure
in place.
I wanted to highlight something. You see that there are three elements here next.
Yes.
And I wanted to start to make an association between the human sense with our detector technology. That is great to understand very, very easily.
Yeah.
So this is a microphone able to hear.
That is ear.
So let's link the hearing of a human sense with the concept, the technology concept of this detector. So the microphone here, you see the black one.
Yes.
This is the display. Doesn't do nothing. In this time is hearing and recognizing that we are speaking and say, okay, it's quiet, it's not a leakage.
So we could actually record the audio of this video with this microphone.
Maybe we can do something. If you can see, I mean, there is the microphone inside.
Yeah.
It's to protect, this is a weather protection.
Okay, all
it's
right.
Just listening, then the software does everything.
Okay, so the software is deciding whether we are talking absolutely, or whether we
absolutely.
Are leaking hydrogen.
Yeah, absolutely. No, yeah. It's is scanning every second what okay. is happening, okay. and this is able to recognize if it is a leakage.
Okay.
But all I right. will explain to you later. Yeah. Or maybe
and,
we
and,
can.
And then you have the smell here?
The smell will be the second detector that I'm going to show,
okay.
and the third is the seeing, that is the flame
yes.
detector.
But okay,
I wanted to keep you okay. on hold no, for we, a while,
we will,
Stephen.
We will see all of them. Okay, perfect.
So, let's go in deep on how does it work at these AV instruments, because I see your arm
yeah.
is still suffering about that. Three main elements. We see that for sure the hydrogen, when it's leaking on a small leakage,
yes.
roughly 2 millimeters, let yes. me say diameter, is physically generating noise.
Mm-hmm.
The noise is an ultrasound.
Yeah.
You see the second picture here.
Mm-hmm.
So what it started to do is to filter. We don't care about the human band,
mm-hmm.
but
mm-hmm.
we are understanding or filtering, sorry,
mm-hmm.
The highest frequency, which is called the ultrasound.
Yeah,
we
yeah.
cannot hear. So
yes,
that is
yes,
the
yes.
first element to avoid the false alarm,
yeah.
right?
Okay, okay.
That is important. The second thing, as I already started to say or mention something, is the artificial neural network, ENN. This is a typical software implementation that's is able to recognize a mapping,
mm-hmm.
scanning,
mm-hmm.
or whatever we wanted to say, and then recognize that this is a truck, this is a compressor,
yeah,
this
okay.
is the high pressure in the pipeline.
Understood,
and then
understood.
When there is a leakage,
yeah.
for instance, I can even, maybe I broke something.
Uh-huh.
You see that if I do any noise,
yeah.
it doesn't go in alarm. So,
ah.
Yeah, because
okay, yeah, we see the indicator here. That's
yeah, it's a decibel.
So
this is
the
decibel.
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 Ah,
so
right.
if someone is doing maintenance, this is a key, and doing noise, this is a possible false alarm that a simple microphone can even trigger, and then
mm-hmm.
think about the shutdown of the hydrogen fueling station. That will be very, very dangerous.
Okay, so I understood that this is essentially listening for when hydrogen leaks, it makes ultrasonic
yes.
noises. Is that always
yeah,
the case?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Always. Always. Because the vibration of the molecular pushed by the pressure.
You know, I ask myself, this is probably the case when you're leaking at, let me say, from 700 bar or 350 bar. Like, what if you're just leaking at very low pressure? Does that also make a noise?
Yeah, there is a limit. There is
There's a limit.
This,
okay.
I mean, the specification says that 2 bars is the minimum one.
Okay.
Of course, there will be a setting in the software
okay.
to even align with the level of the pressure.
Okay.
But in our case of hydrogen, we work with the 30 bars for electrolyzer in
mm-hmm.
some case, and
okay.
then with the hydrogen fueling station
okay.
high pressure.
But some pressure is needed to make this
absolutely.
Yeah.
Without pressure.
No
and
noise.
The second important thing is that it's not affected by the wind,
mm-hmm.
because the wind is bringing the cloud,
yeah.
the leakage, outside or far away from the conventional gas detector that maybe we can introduce now.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah?
Because you mentioned to get the full safety, you need different
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Types, not we,
it's not only one. It's
okay,
not
so
only
bring
one.
It on. I'll try to take away this baby. And as you can see,
be
it,
careful
is,
of,
it is quite heavy. I would
yeah.
say this is at least like maybe 20.
It has to be heavy.
20, 25 kilos?
No, 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 no,
no.
This is
okay.
not, it looks
maybe
heavy.
I just need to do my
okay, you see now the concentration. This is called a conventional gas detector.
Okay.
So, it works with a catalytic concept
yes.
or technology. So there are two pellicers. I can show even
okay, we
here.
Can have
so you
here,
see
yeah.
the two pellicers here. One is blind and the second is at the contact with the hydrogen.
Yes.
When the hydrogen is hitting the sensor,
mm-hmm.
he's down.
Yeah.
What's happened? That there is a variance of resistance.
Mm-hmm.
So the Winston bridge will variance as well as the signal. Then we get the signal and then we transform in what the customer needs, 420 milliamp or free contact for the alarm.
Yeah.
So that is the mainly what is happening here.
Yeah.
And the dimension you see in the pellicer is like that. So
mm-hmm.
it's very thin.
Mm-hmm.
It's very thin. The good thing is that we develop a very strong, let me say, support
mm-hmm.
because that has to will be installed in any type of hydrogen plant.
Mm-hmm.
There might be vibration. Think about the compressor or any kind of rush environment that might be under the.
Yeah.
Pressure again,
yeah. mm-hmm.
and this one can even have a toxic technology
mm-hmm.
like this one.
Mm-hmm.
So the electrochemical, sorry, not toxic, electrochemical concept is
yeah.
based on a kind of battery,
yes.
Let me say, with a mixer inside.
Yeah.
And the mixer is able to variance the signal mm-hmm. when there is hydrogen, up to 1,000 ppm, part per million.
Right. Okay.
That is a good thing because also this detector can have two sensors we
yeah.
have seen in the architecture.
Yeah.
So it's also cost effective for yeah. the customer because
yes,
we
yes,
can
yes.
save one part of this one,
mm-hmm.
the display. This instrument is very capable in when we talk about maintenance. We can swap the sensor because it needs to replace under voltage.
Yeah, okay. And what? So you would actually see the concentration right here?
Yes, yeah.
Okay. What does it send?
The 420 milliamp,
okay.
which is the industrial signal,
yeah.
or we can have
okay.
also free contact. It
yeah.
depends how the...
What is needed?
Yeah,
okay.
yeah.
All right.
Needed.
Okay,
so
cool. mm-hmm.
that is the conventional gas detector.
Mm-hmm.
The cloud has to hit the sensor.
Yeah.
That is when I say the technology of the sound.
Yeah.
Because we have to be lucky.
Yeah. So, that the cloud actually
yeah.
gets to this.
Keep
one.
On
yeah,
all the
yeah.
keep on all the wind effect because
yeah,
maybe
yeah,
we
yeah.
can explain later.
Okay. 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 So first we had the audio, meaning that the guys.
Hearing,
yeah.
yeah.
This
you got
one
the
is
point.
Now smelling, but for smell
correct.
You have to be in the cloud, okay?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Correct, correct. You say something and you see it's linked to the human sense. This
yeah,
is
yeah.
Smelling.
Smelling.
Okay.
okay. All right.
All right. So maybe we can switch to the third one.
Uh-huh.
That is not less important than the other two.
Okay. I'll just move this one across.
Let me. Yeah, yeah. We are doing gym today.
Yes, yes, yes.
Here we go.
Okay.
So
uh-huh.
you see a kind of. Glass here.
Yes.
So there are two sensors. One is infrared and the second is UV, ultraviolet. So there is no camera. It's not recording anything.
Ah.
No. This is a specific for hydrogen. And if we see the diagram, how does it work? Hydrogen
yeah,
flame,
yeah, yeah.
hydrogen flame is very specific, has a very specific infrared radiation.
Yeah,
we are talking about
it,
correct.
No?
It's a 2.95 micro
mm-hmm.
Wavelength,
mm-hmm.
which is different than comparing with the hydrocarbon emission
yeah.
flame. So what's happened? We have tuned our infrared, infrared sensor to this microwave. So in order to see specifically the transparent flame,
yeah.
because transparent, the hydrogen flame is quite dangerous because you cannot see.
Yeah, yeah.
But
I mean, I can see it in the diagram here that this
correct.
This is essentially the area that you and I
we can
see.
Yes.
Yeah, and all our, essentially YouTube happens in this
That is
area.
The rainbow color, let me say.
And this is beyond.
Yeah, it's the
yeah.
upper, this is the lowest with the ultraviolet.
Yes, yes,
why
yes.
we use the UVIR? Because we strongly believe that in order to avoid any false alarm,
yes.
Think about the sun ray.
Yeah.
That might be a triggering the infrared.
Mm.
So and also the how you install the sensor can avoid the possible false mm-hmm. alarm from the site. That is very important.
But there are other sources of infrared there. So for example,
yeah,
I
yeah,
know
yeah.
that many remote controls for TVs have infrared.
Okay, but in this case we are talking about infrared with radiation specific, like when you say the wave when it's hot in
yeah.
the summer from
okay,
the asphalt, is this type of radiation.
Okay.
I think
okay,
that's
okay.
I'm not the expert, but what you say is a very high frequency,
yes.
so
it's
is different. And I
okay.
hope that it doesn't trigger this one.
Trigger. Okay.
No, but
okay.
this is important because,
yeah.
let me say, it's quite at the end of
yeah.
the... possible worst scenario when there is a flame.
Okay, yeah, when there's...
So I hope that this will never work
yeah.
in terms of activating the alarm.
Okay.
It works always, but never trigger the alarm because it means that the situation is quite dangerous.
Okay, so we hope that the other two, this one and the other one,
correct.
Have already
correct.
Said
absolutely.
Something.
Absolutely. That's why
that one comes
you
in.
Are introducing already the last thing.
Yeah.
Why we, as an MSA, we developed these three different technologies specifically for the hydrogen. We call our hydrogen package
mm-hmm.
technology. Technology or protection layer,
mm-hmm.
because the different technology can even see the leakage
mm-hmm.
and the flame, and
yeah.
We can detect it with the ultrasound
yeah.
at the early stage, very
mm-hmm.
early stage. So we are talking about few seconds,
okay.
very few seconds. This one, it takes time in case the cloud is, how to say, move it out
yeah.
With the window,
yeah.
with the window,
yeah.
And that is quite... Depends on the sensor positioning, mm-hmm. so it's important during the design stage mm-hmm. of the plant mm-hmm. where to fix, because that is prevalent affected by the direction of the cloud.
Yeah,
but
okay.
I mean, we have a lot of experience also yeah. On this.
Well, I know that, I mean, having designed a few systems myself, I know that actually once there is even the slight, let me say, chance of a leakage, part of the safety is to try and get all the air out as fast
yes,
as possible.
Evacuation yeah, is the
exactly.
first thing.
So, you know, if you have fans, turn them on or whatever, open doors, windows, anything just to, yeah. and then probably this guy will still be watching.
Yeah, also this guy yeah. is well written in the now hydrogen, also international standard, mm-hmm. which is required the gas detection, like in the electrolyzer.
Is that actually, so if you have a refueling station,
yes.
what kind of sensors are required by law?
Okay, there is no specific requirement. There is the regulation 908080 mm-hmm. Slash one, which is well written that a gas detection is gas and flame is requested to mitigate the possible risk of leakage. That is very important. Okay. It doesn't say you have to use specifically this one, that one, or other technology.
Okay.
But it will be is based on the design of okay. the of the plant that require different.
Okay. All right. Okay. So, last question to that:
yeah.
Is it applicable in all over the world or specific countries? This regulation you just mentioned.
The ISO for the fueling station mm-hmm. or for the electrolyzer are an international standard.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not an expert because that is the standard for the who designed the
yeah.
plant.
Okay.
I mean, I can say that those products are marked for to be installed in dangerous area
yeah,
up to
okay.
zone
Whatever.
One. So
okay.
If you fulfill all the in compliance
okay.
with
all
your
right.
regulation.
Okay, cool.
So now maybe
coming back to the diagram, yeah.
Yeah, this is an important thing. I mean, we say that the wind, like you say, this is a simulation with a specific fluid dynamic software.
Yeah.
We see that depending on the pressure, and if the in this case we are not lucky,
so
the leakage.
The leakage is here.
Yes, that is the leakage point.
Yeah.
Is blowing down.
Yeah.
And you see that at 100 bar,
yeah.
we can have over the LEL at 7 meters.
Okay.
7 meters is far away.
Yeah.
I mean, again, so let's not say that, okay, hydrogen is light molecular goes up.
Mm.
No, hold on. This is a simulation that
the because
likelihood.
Right.
And
okay.
keep in mind, we are talking about 300 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
So because of the pressure is keeping up this shape
mm-hmm.
for a long time.
Okay.
It's enough to have a very dangerous situation.
So,
however,
mm-hmm. yeah.
that is the solution. I mean, we discussed about the technology. We discussed about how this will be deployed in a ideal hydrogen plant
mm-hmm.
or a fueling station or production one. You see that based on the position, like the ultrasound is located at 28 meters.
Yeah.
Immediately, when there is a leakage, can detect the leakage.
Mm-hmm.
The conventional gas detector, this one, the conventional detector is
yeah.
smelling.
Yeah.
In this case, is lucky because
the
gas is going exactly
yeah.
in that direction.
Yeah.
The flame that is on top, in this case, we have no flame.
Yeah.
As I say, we should be lucky that there
yeah.
is no flame. Why?
Yeah.
Because there is a very early detection.
Yeah. Yeah.
There is another important thing. We are talking about a leakage with a 2 millimeter holes. In
okay.
some cases, the compressor is still pushing,
yeah.
because maybe the process instrumentation doesn't recognize that there is a reduction of pressure
mm-hmm.
because it happened when there is a heavy broke of the pipe
mm-hmm.
but in this case it's like a small blowing out
so
that is our scope to protect the
okay.
asset and the people in a dangerous situation.
Okay, wow. Okay, so I mean that's I can say these are like three musketeers and I'm just going to try
three
bring him over here again. So with this guy listening, this guy smelling, and this guy basically looking, you can have more safety in hydrogen
yeah, yeah,
applications, yeah.
yeah?
And that's, I mean, I found that really interesting, especially the listening part. I mean, yeah,
you like
people
it.
To train, to listen what the sound of leaking hydrogen
of course,
is like.
It's also interesting technology.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Claudio.
Thank
this
you to you, Stephen.
Pleasure to show us this. I think we've learned a lot today. If you want to know more or if you want to get in contact with Claudio,
sure.
please go on hyfindr.com. You'll find these kind of equipment there, plus many other things that are needed in the hydrogen economy. If you like this video, please subscribe or drop us a note here. Also, drop us a note on LinkedIn or wherever. Thank you very much for watching.
Thank you,
Claudio, for
coming. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Fecarotta.
And yeah, Stay good building the hydrogen economy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.